From the shining domicile that is Pittsburgh Comics, my old mannered comic shop owner, Colin McMahon, transforms into the world's greatest comic book talking TV host. Join us, true believers, for Comics Now!
Hey everybody, welcome to Comics Now for January 2024. Happy New Year. It's a new year, all sorts of new stuff coming, and I'm going to try some new stuff here at the store. So we're going to be doing some new displays, we're going to be doing some new promotions, and I'm going to be posting, or trying to post, a lot more information about older stuff to let you know a little bit about the history of comics and why I love doing this. So keep an eye on the website and social media for that kind of stuff. As far as what we're doing in the store, we're kicking off the year with a focus on Daredevil. It's one of my favorite characters, one of the few books I have a full, complete run of at home. So we're going to kick off. Tim's made a great display with a bunch of Daredevil graphic novels. So for the beginning of January, we're going to do double points on all Daredevil graphic novels. Book club. We had a great turnout last time, so we're hoping to keep that going. We're doing on the 26th of January, and we're going to do a book called Stray Dogs. This is by Tony Fleece and Trish Forstner, a book about stray dogs, and it's a cross between Lady and the Tramp meets Silence of the Lambs. It looks like a Disney story, but it is much, much darker, and it was really, really good. So Friday, January 26th for that. As New Year's kicks off, like I said, there's a lot of new books coming. So let's start talking about them, and we'll start with Marvel Comics. So from Marvel Comics, the biggest one they have coming out in January is the brand new Ultimate Spider-Man series. This is written by Jonathan Hickman with art by Marco Cicchetto. After the events of Ultimate Invasion, the world needs a hero. Who will rise up to take on that responsibility? Prepare to be entangled in a web of mystery and excitement as the all-new Ultimate Spider-Man comic redefines the wall crawler for the 21st century. Now, lots of other stuff, too. We have Avengers Twilight. This is a new one from Chip Zdarsky and Daniel Acuna. In a gleaming new world of prosperity, Captain America is no more. But Steve Rogers still exists, floating through an America where freedom is an illusion, where the Avengers are strangers and his friends are long dead. But is the dream? How do you assemble Avengers in a world that doesn't want them? It was basically pitched to us as Dark Knight Captain America. So we'll see where that goes. And now, since the Hellfire Gala, the X-Men have been falling. The Fall of X storyline has been continuing, and we're finally getting to the end of this. And the first is The Fall of the House of X. This is by Jerry Dugan and Lucas Wernick. Mutant kind has never had a greater fall. From the highs of Krakoa, their own glorious nation, a place where they were safe and happy, to the lowest of lows. Outlawed, hunted, killed, most of their kind missing or dead. And now one of their greatest leaders, Cyclops, is on a trial facing a death penalty. Ready or not, the time has come for the X-Men to make their final stand against the forces that have struck them low. The day is now. The place is here. The tale of the House of Xavier Built will long be told, and few will forget this darkest chapter. Now comes half the story that will bring the Krakoa Age to its conclusion. The other half is being told in The Rise of the Powers of X. This is Kieran Gillen and R.B. Silva doing this one. 10 years ago, the mutants returned from their exile to try to reclaim the Earth from the forces of Orcus. They failed. Now within the victorious Orcus, with their greatest gauntlet choking the world, Nimrod and Omega Sentinel put their plan within a plan into action. They are to summon their binary god to consume everything in their accession. All that stands between them is the X-Men. What can they do? They're the X-Men. They'll find a way. That's their power. So begins a story beyond time and space, with the rise of powers beyond our petty human intelligence. This is the other half of the story that will bring the Krakoa Age to its conclusion. We also have a new Cable book by Fabian Nicieza and Scott Eaton. All the signs are here. The Neocracy is coming. And with it comes not only the end of mutant kind, but all of the humankind as well. As if rescuing young Nate from the ongoing threat of Orcus weren't enough, can Cable root out this growing threat and decimate it before the Neocracy has a chance to take hold? But is he already too late to change the future? We also have Dead X-Men number one. Death was only the beginning. When the world turned against Krakoa, these five mutants lost their lives, but their mission as X-Men is just getting started. To preserve Xavier's dream, they must accomplish the impossible, or die again trying. Spinning out from Rise of the Powers of X, discover who are the dead X-Men. And then we also have the Resurrection of Magneto. This is Al Ewing and Luciano Vecchio. On Krakoa, resurrection from the dead was as easy as completing a circuit, but Krakoa fell. The time of easy miracles is over, and only the hard roads are left. Now it falls to Storm, as the epic conclusion to the Krakoan Age looms, to bring their oldest enemy home to fight against the fall of the House of X. But after all he did, and all that was done to him, can Magneto bear to return? Now over in Spider-Man, we have Gang War is continuing. It's in Spider-Man 41 and 42. The Deadly Hands of Kung Fu Gang War number 2. Luke Cage Gang War 3. Daredevil Gang War 3. Or Gang War 2. Spider-Woman 3. And Miles Morales 15. Confusing. We also have in the Spider-World Kid Venom Origins. And this collects the full four parts of Kid Venom from the Death of the Venomverse issues. Plus, there's a glimpse at what the future holds for Kid Venom. Planet of the Apes returns in Beware of the Planet of the Apes number 1. In a hostile world run by aggressive gorillas, scientists Cornelius and Zira are the only apes alive who see value in the mute, dumb human race. But even they know human capabilities have severe limits. So when their nephew Lucius goes missing, it is with great trepidation that they turn to a human ally, a young woman who will someday earn the moniker Nova. We also have Jackpot number 1. This is also a Gang War tie-in. Mary Jane Watson, a.k.a. Jackpot, gets her first solo super story. New York City is in chaos as the super-powered criminal gangs are at war, and it's all hands on deck. It's a baptism by fire, but come on, this is Mary Jane. What can't she handle? Also, Power Pack is back with a retro story, Power Pack Into the Storm. Alex, Julie, Jack, and Katie Power are superhero siblings determined to do their part to protect the world, despite their young age. The problem is that their parents don't want them to have powers and can't know that they do. But when their friend Franklin Richards has a premonition of a galactic threat hurtling their way, the Power siblings will have to decide what kind of heroes they want to be and what they're willing to give up along the way. Original creators Louise Simonson and June Brigman return to explore an exciting new adventure from the early days of the Power Pack. And it's the 50th anniversary of giant size comics for Marvel Comics, where every series got a big giant size one, the most famous one being Giant Size X-Men number 1. But so they're doing an anniversary, 50th anniversary. So this month we get Giant Size Spider-Man. This is by Cody Ziegler and Ivan Kaleo. It's Spider-Man versus Venom. Dylan Brock, a.k.a. Venom, has a bone or a brain to pick with Miles Morales. We also have another Spider-Man event. It's a weekly one. It's Miguel O'Hara Spider-Man 2099. This is written by Steve Orlando. Miguel O'Hara teams up with Blade 2099 to take on a new horrific threat to Nueva York, introducing the Marvel Zombie of 2099. He lives, he strikes, and no spider can hold him. Will Spider-Man be able to stop the ever-evolving zombie infection before it takes hold of his mother and the citizens of the barrio? Well, we'll find out. We also have a brand new Vengeance of Moon Knight, new series. Moon Knight apparently died at the end of the last series of Moon Knight, so we have a new one, Vengeance of Moon Knight, also by Jed McKay. Clad in the black of mourning, the midnight mission remains. But who is left to keep the faith, and how have they been changed by the Black Spectre's masterstroke? The next chapter of Moon Knight starts here, as the congregants of the midnight mission pick up the pieces and carry on the mission, and find themselves faced with a mysterious new enemy in eerily familiar vestments. We also have Marvel Meow number 1. Marvel's most fearsome and furriest heroes are here to save the day and beg for treats in the process. We have some facsimile editions, the first being X-Men number 4. This is the first Brotherhood of Evil Mutants, Quicksilver, Scarlet Witch, Toad, and Mastermind. We also have Amazing Spider-Man 252, the first black costume, and Marvel Hero Superhero Secret Wars number 1. Wolverine has a big thing coming. In 41 starts the Sabretooth War. The most violent Wolverine story ever told. Get ready for the showdown to end all showdowns, Wolverine versus Sabretooth. It's been years since these heavy hitters have crossed paths in the Marvel Universe, but as Krakoa falls, so rises Sabretooth, and he's out for revenge. They threw Victor Creed in the pit, but he's free and wielding an army of Sabretooths, and he will prove once and for all why he is Logan's ultimate nemesis. We also have a new Marvel Voices Legends, which is a big compilation book. And then Star Wars Universe gives us a new Thrawn Alliances and Star Wars Visions Takashi Okazaki. So that's what we got coming from Marvel. Now on to DC Comics. Lots of new stuff coming from DC Comics in January as well. The big one is Action Comics. They're turning it into like a creator roundtable, and it's kicking off with Jason Aaron. Fresh from his run from Marvel, he's now over at DC. He's got the Batman miniseries Offworld going right now, and now he's on to Superman as well. So Jason Aaron writes Superman for the very first time, teaming up with all-star artist John Timms to prevent a startling new vision of the Man of Steel's strangest foe, Bizarro. When Superman's doppelganger discovers a dark secret about himself, it unleashes the most dangerous version of Bizarro the world has ever seen. We also have a Trinity special. This is written by Tom King, featuring DC's brightest new star, Trinity. Discover Lizzie's earliest adventures as she takes the world of heroes by storm. Titans Beast World wraps up, where we get issues 4, 5, and 6 this month. And in the end, it's Dr. Hate revealed as Raven makes her final stand against the chaotic evil sorcerer. The Titans race against time to cure the world of the epidemic caused by Beast Boy. How far will the team go? How much will the friends sacrifice? Watch as the DCU is forced to evolve or die in this shocking conclusion. We also have Titans Beast World Tour Star City. City of the Stars. Father and son Archer duo Oliver Queen and Connor Hawke are reunited in the face of evil as they investigate rumors of harrowing experiments taking place at the City Aquarium. Across town, Black Canary's cry becomes lethal as she succumbs to the Beast Boy's spores. Can the city's newest hero, Red Canary, stand up to her idol? We also have Titans number 7, and the battle for Tempest's soul rages on. Brother Eternity shows his true self as the Titans battle for their friend with the hope of freeing him from the enigmatic cult leader's spell. Will exposing the Church of Eternity and their ulterior motives turn the tide of the war for Earth? Over in Batman, they are wrapping up the current storyline Mind Bomb. Zur-En-Arr has done the unthinkable, and now cut off from everything and everyone, Batman has to face off against the most devastating enemy in a brutal fight for the future as the specter of the Joker hangs over everything. The stunning conclusion to Mind Bomb is here. We also have, I'm super excited about this one, John Constantine Hellblazer is back. Cy Spurrier and Aaron Campbell did an amazing job, and then it just ended on a cliffhanger of all things. But I guess enough letters have been written and they're bringing it back, which makes me happy. So now we have Hellblazer dead in America. At last, as you demanded, the celebrated creative team of Cy Spurrier and Aaron Campbell have returned to Hellblazer. John Constantine has cheated death once again, but his heart's not beating, his body is decaying, and he, his friend Nat, and his son Noah are on the run in America, wanted for murder. Naturally, it's all John's fault. It always is. But as it turns out, Dream himself needs John's help. Something terrible has taken root in America, and it's using sand from Dream's pouch to impose its will. If John can put a stop to it, he might be able to parlay that favor into a chance to save all their lives. But he's going to need help from someone he hasn't spoken to in years. Someone he wasn't always all that kind to. Someone or something. Okay, now on to Image Comics. Image Comics has a bunch of exciting stuff coming in January. Really looking forward to these. First up is Cobra Commander number 1. This is Josh Williamson is also writing this one. The rise of Cobra begins here. In a world where the Cobra organization hasn't formed, one man's sinister plans to utilize the mysterious alien substance known as Energon send shockwaves across the globe. Who is Cobra Commander? Where does he come from? And what horrors is he planning to unleash that will rock the world and maybe the universe to its core? We also have a new one, The Colonized, where there's aliens, there's zombies. These otherworldly threats converge in the secluded Carbon Falls Collective. A second generation off-the-gridder, Huxley Robertson, is dealing with both loss and the Elders' pushback against his plans for a fully sustainable town. Amidst these volatile circumstances, a vainglorious alien explorer inadvertently reanimates the town's dead. Add a rogue ATF agent into the mix, and let's just say this is a bad time for the sleepy town to be cut off from the outside world. So we have Moon Man number one. This is by Kid Cudi. Scott Townsend is ready for a quiet life. Whatever went wrong on the failed moon mission, whatever happened in those missing minutes the cameras didn't capture, all he really wants is to settle down back home. But those missing minutes hold an earth-shattering secret, and with all eyes turned to him, Scott will soon find himself becoming something the world has never seen before. And a real big one is Ghost Machine One-Shot. This is Jeff Johns has gathered a bunch of other creators to work just for his Ghost Machine imprint, and this is kicking everything off. From the powerhouse creative collective that is Ghost Machine comes an extra-sized 48-page special introducing its all-new shared universe of strange, fun, and action-packed characters. Geiger, Redcoat, Rook, the Rocketfellers, and many, many more. What ties Geiger, Redcoat, Widow X, and the other mysterious historical heroes of the unnamed together? Why is Rook the key to saving the war-torn world of Exodus? How will everyone's soon-to-be favorite family of the future adapt to a new life in the present? Characters you know, creators you know, characters you'll love, this is Ghost Machine. We also have The Weatherman, Volume 3, Number 1. The conclusion to one of the most compelling science fiction series of all time begins here. Local weatherman Nathan Bright has been forced undercover as the notorious terrorist Ian Black. But who is Ian Black? The answers may be the key to saving the world and Nathan as well. But does Nathan deserve saving? Does humanity? Now on to Boom Studios. We have a new one called Pine and Merrimack. This is written by Kyle Starks. After a lifetime of witnessing the worst that humanity has to offer, former homicide detective Linnea Kent has decided to put all of that behind her. Alongside her husband Parker, a former professional MMA fighter and the unofficial brawn to her brains, she's opening up a quiet little detective agency in a sleepy town on the corner of Pine and Merrimack. At first, the simple cases this nook of the world has to offer were exactly what she was looking for. But there's more to the quaint town than Linnea could have possibly imagined, and something truly sinister pulling the strings. Now on to Dynamite. We have a brand new Lilo and Stitch comic. It's written by Greg Pak. Life seems to have calmed down for Experiment 626 and his new family on Earth, at least until evil aliens come hunting for everyone's favorite blue-furred troublemaker. The kicker? They're using giant robots that are powered by Stitch's own DNA. Will Lilo's beloved pet be able to take on these villains and lead them away from his adopted planet and loved ones? And even if he succeeds, will he be able to find his way home? We also have a new Gargoyles book, Quest Number 1, written by Gargoyles creator Greg Weissman. Thwarted in her early attempt to gain control of the ancient magical artifacts known as the original keys to power, the evil Demona has set her sights on three new keys that will give her the ability to make any human in her vicinity a willing puppet. All that stands between Demona and world domination are Goliath and the Manhattan Clan. We also have a new James Bond 007 book. This one's written by Garth Ennis. A relic of the Cold War, the deadly compound Stavolda has a long-buried connection with MI6. So when it mysteriously reappears in disturbing circumstances, the agency naturally assigns its best operative to get to the bottom of things, 007 himself, James Bond. But Bond isn't the only one to have carried the 00 rank, and with it MI6's secrets. Former agent Archibald Tyrone is another, and he's also carrying a grudge, one that's aimed squarely at the heart of His Majesty's Secret Service. Titan has a new Rebel Moon book that's based on the new movie that's out there from the Zack Snyder movie. Massive has a big one this month. It's Sean Gordon Murphy's Zorro Man of the Dead. He's trying to reimagine Zorro, which should be fun. Don Quixote meets Narcos in this modern reimagining, delivering a fresh take on the legendary swashbuckling hero. Diego is a young man who is convinced that he's Zorro, As a child, he suffered a psychotic break after witnessing the murder of his parents by the drug cartel in his village. To cope with the trauma, he embraced the 200-year-old legend of Zorro by donning the mask, training with the sword, and declaring war on the narcos for the sake of his people. They also have another one called Crashdown. This is drawn by Ben Templesmith, who we haven't seen in a while. Equal parts Lost and Alien with a Lovecraftian twist. Crashdown delivers a dark vision of our world's final days. The Earth is dead. Humanity's last hope is the distant planet Empyrean and a ship full of colonists ready to repopulate our civilization. But what happens when their new home doesn't want them there and it fights back? You also have Dillinger Escape Plan number one. I'm interested in this because Ben Roberts is writing it. And Ben works at Acme Comics down in North Carolina, who I'm good friends with. It's a string of assassinations made by a politically motivated killer known only to the public as the Quill, serves as the spark to ignite a full-scale revolution. Now from Dark Horse, we have a new Avatar book based on the video game that's coming. We also have Blue Book Returns. This is James Tinian and Michael Avon Oeming. This one's set in 1947. This ambitious nonfiction comic experience depicts the stories of UFO abductions with an eye to capturing the strange essence of those encounters. In 1947, Kenneth Arnold flew his Cal Air A2 over the skies of the Pacific Northwest when all of a sudden he saw a blinding flash of silver light. What followed was a bizarre and difficult to explain encounter with several flying objects that would change the course of his life forever. They also have If You Find This, I'm Already Dead by Matt Kent and Dan McDade, a multi-dimensional cosmic odyssey presented in pulp magazine-sized format. Robin is a big city reporter embedded with the U.S. Marines, heading to the hostile pocket universe called Terminus. 10 minutes in, the entire Marine squad is wiped out, and she has to survive and report on her own. Terminus is full of cosmic wonders and sci-fi gods that are in the middle of a political power struggle. The language is an alien, and the politics are deadly. Can she survive long enough to figure out what's going on and get home to tell her story? We also have Kill All Immortals from Zach Kaplan. Succession meets John Wick with immortal Vikings. 1,000 years ago, Viking explorer Eric the Red and his 4 adult children discovered a mysterious source of immortality. Now in our modern world, they are an enigmatic billionaire family with a powerful banking empire. But when Eric's only daughter, Frey Oswald, seeks to finally be free from her family's influence, she must be prepared to reveal their supernatural secrets and confront her well-trained siblings in a deadly and epic struggle for power. Get ready for a bloodthirsty immortal fight like no other. Ahoy Comics has a fun one for us. Acid Chimp and Business Dog One-Shot by Mark Russell. Ahoy's breakout animal stars come muzzle to muzzle in this 5th anniversary one-shot. Business Dog from Billionaire Island controls the wealth of nations. Acid Chimp from My Bad has been abducted by crooks who want him to kill the canine trillionaire with corrosive acid. And why wouldn't he? Splashing acid is the only thing that Acid Chimp enjoys. American Mythology has an interesting one this month called Dracula After Man. Vampires have always fed on the lifeblood of innocent victims. But what if there were no sheep left in the stable? After a million-year-long slumber, Dracula wakes up to find Earth and humanity fundamentally changed and enslaved by a vicious alien species. Faced with this strange new world, the Lord of the Vampires must adapt to a nightmarish existence or perish alongside the remnants of the people he fed upon. Mad Cave has an interesting new one called Dear Editor. A John Doe slaying lures a journalist into a world of political intrigue. A Wi-Fi-enabled grotto and a station locker full of secrets. For Bucky, an editor of the crime beat at The Truth, it's all in a day's work. But he also happens to be a deer. Will he chase down his last story in this antler noir series? Oni has a new one called Jill and the Killers. Returning to school after the unsolved disappearance of her mother, teenager Jill Estrada can't wait for things to return to normal. Even as her friends become compulsively obsessed with Box Killers, a true crime subscription game where each month's unsolved case is custom tailored to the life of its player. There's only one catch. Jill's game seems to be all too real. And when her clues begin to connect a series of disappearances in her town, Jill and her friends must uncover the truth behind these mysterious crimes before one of their own becomes the next victim. So that's all we got as far as fancy new number ones that are coming out in January. But all, again, all your regular series are continuing on. We're still getting Batman and Avengers and X-Men are falling. And everything is still coming out. Here at the store, like I said, I'm going to be changing up some displays. We're going to be running some new promotions. And I'm going to be really trying to do a lot of educational stuff on the website, giving you just a little bit of history, a little bit of information about older stuff. So stay tuned and keep an eye out for that. As always, the website's PittsburghComics.com. Facebook is Pittsburgh Comics. And Twitter and Instagram are PGH Comics. We're doing Daredevil as the Double Points Spotlight of the Month. And Book Club is on the 26th. And we're doing Stray Dogs. So thanks for watching and stay tuned to Comics Previews Theater. See ya.
Then, the Krakoon Age was remarkable for the advancement in mutant technology. By combining their powers into circuits, the mutants formed a nation that was carbon negative and spanned several worlds. There is a consensus among historians that the primordial circuit in mutant technology was a fastball special. The name of the physical attack where Consulsus pitch Wolverine with uncanny accuracy at a target. Now, in the dark days following the third Hellfire Gaia, Colossus and Logan were infiltrating the sewers under the Paris courthouse, and their dark moods led them to invert the fastball special. Though they were having a difficult time coming up with a name for it.
Huddlebound, the fifth after special.
Awful. That's a terrible name, Pete. I thought you Russians were poets.
I'm not feeling very poetic, Tovarish.
I reckon not.
Let's go reverberate Cyclops.
What if we called that move the Screwball Special?
Why?
Cause they were screwed.
Duh.
Cyclops, someone's come to see you.
Is it a tall, smart, funny redhead with sharp objects floating around her?
No. Dr. Isla Gregor and Karema Rappender.
Scott Summers.
Dr. Gregor, this might surprise you to hear, but you've been on my mind.
Oh? Do tell. Have you been replaying Making Me a Widow over and over?
No. I have no memory of leading the assault on your mother mold. I've been thinking about the price of war.
Some of us paid more than others.